Good evening and welcome to Millennium Stage. And now please welcome to the stage Crystal Tamorbot.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the Millennium Stage. We are very happy that you were able to join for Reflections of Morin-khuur by Khatanbold Urlagbaatar tonight. My name is Balorma Tamorbat. I am here to guide you through the evening and explain some of the Mongolian traditional songs, arts, and culture, and the pieces that we are going to play so you would have a better understanding of what we are performing. Before we officially start, I would like to thank everyone who made this day possible, including Mrs. Zaltsaya Sanjimitov from the Embassy of Mongolia to the USA, Millennium Stage organizers and staff members, our sponsoring organizations and individuals, which are Pyramid Granite, Sakura International, Art Granite and Marble, Top Master Marble and Granite, Mr. Mintzahan's family, Mr. Boltbatar's family, Mr. Batur's family, Mr. Chajasurin's family, and our fellow musicians who are playing with Khatanbold tonight for their hard work and dedication. Last but not least, our family and friends for their unconditional love and support. The purpose of tonight's show is to introduce you to Mongolian art, culture, and its nomadic lifestyle through the beautiful sound of morin-khuur, or in English, horsehead fiddle. Morin-khuur consists of a trapezoid wooden frame sound box which has two strings made out of horsehair. They're in two different sizes. The larger one is called male string, and it is made out of 130 stallion's hair. And the smaller one is called female string. It's made out of 105 mare's hair. UNESCO declared morin-khuur as one of the masterpieces of the oral and intangible heritage of humanity. The legend about the origin of morin-khuur is that once there was a shepherd named Namjil the Kuko. He was given a flying horse, and he would mount it every night to see his beloved. One day, a jealous woman had cut off the horse's wings. So the grieving shepherd made horsehead fiddle out of the now wingless and dead horse body, skin and tail, and played songs for his dead horse. Morin-khuur not only plays a major role in Mongolian art and music, but also it is deeply embedded in how Mongols live and how nomadic culture exists. We all came together to this stage to have experienced our art, culture, and lifestyle to its fullest. The solo musician, Khatanbold Urlagbaatar, is an accomplished, talented, passionate young musician, and he will be joined by 11 other professional performers and musicians throughout the evening. Our evening, tonight's show, is divided into three main parts. And the first part is mainly Mongolian folk songs, music, and dances. The very first piece we are playing is called Durvung Erd. Durvung means four in Mongolian. Erd is one of the Mongolian ethnic groups whose ancestors' home is in the westernmost part of Mongolia, in the Altai region. And the playing style is called tatlak, and tatlak imitates Mongolian herders' livestock, like horses and camels' steps. Please welcome Khatanbold Urlagbaatar.
Thank you.
hope you enjoy. Oops. Sorry. I hope you enjoyed the Durbung art. The next two performers are also big representatives of Mongolian culture and nomadic society. And they are also identified by UNESCO as the masterpieces of oral and intangible heritage of humanity. The first one we are playing is a long song. The song is called long, not only it's because long. Actually, the syllables are extended to longer duration while being sung. And the piece we are playing is called Oihung Jambu Tiwing Narang, or in English, Under the Sun of Plaid World. And the second performance we are going to be performing tonight is Bibilge, or it is Mongolian traditional dance. Bibilge has different versions throughout Mongolia and other nomadic cultures. But the whole dance itself is the Mongolian aspects, different aspects of day-to-day life, and movements of hands and shoulders and legs express Mongol herders' everyday lifestyle, such as milking the cow, cooking, hunting, and household labor and custom and traditions.
Thank you.
So now, as I previously introduced, Bibi Ilge is coming up, and Tilpeng is also the horsehead fiddler. He's going to join Khatanbold Urlagbaatar. Please welcome the musicians. husband. Thank you, everyone. I hope you enjoyed the performances. This one is the last of our first section, and it is called Altay Magdal, or Praise for the Altay Mountains. As nomadic people, we respect and acknowledge the spirit and power of our surroundings, our nature, mountains, rivers, even the stones, everything has spirit. That's why we praise our mountains. That's why we praise those things that surround us. And this song is the praise for Altay. I hope you would enjoy it. So now we are here at the beginning of the second stage, or second section. And in this section, we're playing the music that are composed by both international and Mongolian composers. The first of our four pieces in this section is called morin-khuur, or in English, Through the Speed of a Stallion, composed by In this piece, I would like everybody to imagine Mongolian beautiful steppes, vast openness, eternal blue sky, underneath it, running and mounting stallions. Please welcome the musicians. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed Armok Hulin Hortar by Gay Altangirl. So now next is Monty Shardas by Victoria Monty. Please enjoy.
Thank you.
I hope you had a great time listening to the previous performance. The next two performers are both Mongolian pieces. The Mongolian horsehead fiddlers play a great many songs as a quartet. And this first song that they're going to perform is called Idringin Gob, or the Gobi of Idring, composed by Chinzorik Tidungish. The following the quartet, morin-khuur concert, or concert with the horsehead fiddle, composed by Ulzibayer. Please enjoy the performance.
Thank you. Thank you.
Is everybody enjoying your evening so far? Are you ready for even more extraordinary? Yes? Okay. So now our third and the last section starts. This section has more modern music composed by both international and Mongolian composers. Some of it you will recognize. And the first two performances is sad romance composed by Tha Nu. And then the next one is Audimus by Clocks and Cloud Band. Let's welcome the performers.
Thank you.
is just beautiful. Can they get one more plot? So we have two more performances left. The one that's coming up now is What Are Words? Some of you guys may know American Idol, Chris Medina, and Coldplay, Viva La Vida.
Thank you.
so now we are ready for our last performance. It's called Hartes Hartek. Let's welcome the performers.
Yeah.
a beautiful performance it was. Let's invite everyone to the stage, all of our tonight's stars, tonight's performers, dancers, contortionists, other musicians. Our sala musician, Khatanbold Urlagbaatar. Pianist, morin-khuur. Cellist, Katie Chambers. Drummer, Throat singer, horsehead player, Khatanbold Urlagbaatar. Grand horsehead player, Harpist Anastasia Pike. Contortionist Mantha Irtambat. Dancer Vidgirma Batchathong. Dancer Tingle Saham Bandrach. Horsehead player Pitman. Thank you all for coming out to this beautiful evening to Kennedy Center and Millennium Stage. I hope you enjoyed all the performance. I just wanted to let you know that as a nomad Mongol, we hope that we accomplished our goal tonight. And I hope you learn a little bit about our culture, our music, and where we are from, where our heritage is. And let's end today this way. And we have souvenirs being sold at the back of the hallways, Mongolian souvenirs, if you are interested.